it's hard to explain what drives one to do something. There's something in life that just sometimes propels us to act. It was just there. I don't know exactly what it was. I needed to write, and that's always been a part of my life, needing to untangle what's going on, needing to express it, and eventually needing to write that one song or two songs or three songs turned into writing of an album. So the album has just come out. It's really exciting. And now the touring begins.
We both come up on different streets, and they were both the streets of shame. You know, they're both dirty, both me. Yeah, and even the dreams were the same. Well, I dreamed a dream for you, and now your dream is real. So tell me, honey, now how can you look at me as if I was just another one of your deals?
Being on the road is a really interesting place. One night, we play this big, beautiful theater in Montreal. And the next day, we're in LA playing this lovely little house concert. It was inspired by that time that I spent in the north, and I wrote a prayer song called Masi. It's really a song about, you know, people coming together, just remembering that we come from the same source. I mean, we breathe the same air. We're going to Austin, Texas, to be performing at South by Southwest. It's my first time there. It's really exciting. I hear it's a bit of a madhouse. And then from there, we're embarking on an American tour. And then after that, we're embarking on a European tour.
It feels nice coming in, like, before the music festival starts and, you know, coming in during the film part and stuff and exploring that side of things, which is also dear to me.
It'd be really nice when the band comes in.
But, you know, I'm a bit of a free spirit, too. I kind of like wandering around places and exploring for myself. I'm really excited to be here.
I am. I'm really excited.
I'm very excited. I haven't slept very much since we got here. I guess that's part of the experience.
I was born in Montreal, but my parents were born and raised in Egypt, and they're both originally from Lebanon, so I guess my ancestry on both sides is Lebanese. I do think that the Eastern and Western side of me influences my writing and my music. I've often felt like I'm caught between two worlds in so many ways. Like, I'm caught between, you know, a very mathematical mind and a very artistic heart.
Just the whole vibe has changed. I mean, it's just gotten much louder, much crazier, much more people, and this is just the first day of the music festival. I think that as the next few days go on, it's gonna get crazier.
Watching You Think is pretty raw. It's a lot of reflections of life and love and loss and longing. It's getting a group of really wonderful musicians playing music in a room together. Pierre Marchand is a wonderful producer and musician and songwriter and person. I met him years ago, and I approached him again when I was starting to write this album. He was great support during the album. He basically, I'd play the songs for him, and he'd give me advice on, you know, how to record them and so forth. And then as I was recording them, I'd have listening sessions with him, similar to what I did with Leonard, and he would give me his feedback on what I should do, what I should change, what instrumentation needed to be added or removed. And eventually we ended up mixing the album at his studio and recording some of the songs there.
From Mulholland Drive to Skid Row,
You gave me a reality show down the freeways of LA. I met Leonard in Montreal. We live in the same neighborhood, and we bumped into each other in the street and started talking and then became friends. And it's one of those things that you look back on and say, wow, that was a nice, lucky day. But he's definitely one of my most trusted mentors. It gives me confidence in what I'm doing. To have his respect and his support like that is really invaluable. So we're in my hotel room in downtown Austin, and I think it's around 3:30 or 4 in the morning. Love the way you wait for me, ever so patiently. How you lie near my guitar, oblivious of how gorgeous you are. Elsa's Lullaby is a song about my dog, who I've had for the last almost 12 years. At one point, I was touring across Canada, and I met a little girl who fell in love with Elsa and said, wow, you must have so many songs written for your dog. And I thought, geez, I don't have any.
Elsa, love of my life, you make me feel so free. Let's run away together.
Today's the day, and tonight is the day, too.
So I'm surprised we're not rehearsing right now.
Yeah.
We're tight, but we're good.
When she's on stage, there's something happening between her and the audience. It's a communication, like the energy transfer between the audience and her is really there. So at a certain point, like they feel like she's really talking to them, and because she is talking to them.
The pre-show ritual consists of singing ooze.
Industry to survive in today, and I would love this album to get out there. I don't know, I hope that this album travels and finds its way to the people who want to find it.
When I was a kid, I questioned everything. Needed to know where I go when I shed this skin. Lying in bed night after night, I tried hard to imagine what might take the place of this world we're living in, where we'd all go and how we'd all fit in. I guess back then my biggest fear was when I left here that I might spend